What is this? 6-2? And this is parallelograms. Four key properties. Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are congruent. Opposite angles are congruent. Consecutive angles. That's angles that are next to each other. Consecutive angles are supplementary. And who remembers what supplementary means? Good. And add means? They sum 180. Everybody okay with that? All right, so if you got a parallelogram, bless you. And remember these? The little red triangle on the side means that it's parallel to the other side with the little red triangles on it. So these would get the little red triangles. That means the left side and the right side are parallel, and the top and the bottom are parallel to each other. Okay? So if this angle down here in the bottom left is equal to 70, and you had to find these other three, all right, what is this angle equal to right here? Consecutive angles, 110, good. These two got to add up to 180, don't they? Opposite angles are congruent. So what's this one? Good. What's this one? 110. Okay? Opposite angles are congruent. Consecutive angles are supplementary. Yes?
Would that apply to the congruent of the triangles up there? Would it still be a parallelogram?
Say that one more time. Well, if you get a shape and there's no marks on the shape, but this is 80 and this is 80 and this is 100 and this is 100, Right, because if opposite sides, and that's what we'll cover tomorrow when you do the converse of this theorem, is that if the opposite angles are congruent, and if consecutive angles sum 180, then parallel, 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 and parallel. Okay? And same with, you know, sides congruent. So, how would you solve for x here? Good. X plus 2 equals 2x plus 3. Subtract x from each side. 2 is going to equal x plus 3. And then subtract 1, subtract 3. And negative 1 equals x. But that's odd. I probably wrote the problem down wrong, but yeah, I did. But you get the concept, right? Because you would still, if x is negative 1, negative 1 plus 2 would be 1. That side would be equal to 1. It's a short side. What's 2 times negative 1? Negative 2 plus 3 is 1. So it still works. You get the idea? Not a whole lot to this section, is there?
No.
Okay. Very well done, class. Very well done. How about something like this picture? And maybe this is 5A, and this is, 17A plus 48. How could you solve for A now? Very good. Alright, those two added together have to equal 180. And you'd have to combine like terms. Okay? Subtract 48 divided by 22. Say that again. Those two are not equal to each other, are they? Opposite ones are. This would be 5a. Those two are equal to each other, but next two add up to 180. So the 5a plus the 17a plus 48 equal 180. Once you solve for A, you could plug it in and find out the actual angle measure. Alright? Alright, look on page 381. And up top, see where it says lesson check? That's where you're doing 1 through 10. Number 11, the developing proof problem, we're not going to do today. So your 1 through 10 starts on the top of the page. And then if you turn the page, you'll find 12 through 16, which is the rest of the assignment. Okay?